The Making of a Carnival Queen. I am your host, Raynell Carroll, Queen of Carnival 2013. It has been 3 long years since we've had the Queen of Carnival competition, but we're ready to take you on the 2023 journey. But first, let's have a recap of the 2019 Queen of Carnival, Shanakisha Francis.
Miss Theatrical Lighting and Sound Effects!
Infused with charisma, courage, and intelligence, Azaria Moore, 24, Miss Stonewall Reloaded.
Miss Lava International, Marissa Carbon, 23.
Village Cake Mecca, bringing a slice of Antiguan culture, Shanakisha Francis, 22, Miss Cool and Smooth.
We having a good time.
This is Stan Winter from Antigua representing for Julian.
I could feel the heat rising, the temperature climbing. We're more than ready to take this carnival season. No matter if rain falling, we still coming here whining. Nothing can put we down. So put up your hand and let them know that we come out to take a wine. No matter the condition, we can't get enough of it.
Miss Cool and Smooth.
Just let the rhythm take ya. Rock, rock and let it take ya. Just let the rhythm take ya to paradise. We having a good time. When you see we on the road, body to body. We having a good time. In every fetish you can find we body to body. You know that's how we party.
We on the road to fulfill our mission. Don't care who watching we.
You are now a young entrepreneur. What life lessons have you learned from opening your own business, Majesty Boutique?
Being a young entrepreneur is not a bed of roses. I am only 23 years old. There was a lot of persons who tried to tell me, try another aspect, go in another virtue.
How have your siblings empowered you to be the woman you are today?
Well, growing up with about 4, 5, 6, there's so many, I'm sorry. You know I love you, there's so many of you, sometimes you know you just drive me crazy.
As an arts and craft enthusiast, how would you help to develop the Buy Local Arts and Craft Initiative being promoted by the Cultural Development Division?
How I would go about that is by proper marketing. That's the only way we have the ability to make the arts and craft environment larger and encourage our people to buy local and support local.
Tell us, how would you encourage young men to explore their passion for the arts?
This question actually hits home as a woman involved in the arts. I think that it is widely perceived that only females participate in performing arts and anyone who is effeminate, and that is not true. Our young men need to realize that you don't have to be gay to have a burning desire for the arts. And I think this is one of the issues that is really crippling our cultural and creative sector here in Antigua and Barbuda. So I would encourage our young men to be bold and assertive and to pursue their dreams and not that of our society.
How do you think someone can overcome adversities in life?
In order to overcome adversities in life, I believe this person should look for other ways to go around these adversities.
How have you used your associate's degree in international business as a stepping stone in pursuing your career?
To be quite honest, Phil, when I applied to the Antigua State College, international business wasn't the subject area I wanted to study.
We having a good time. This is Dan Winter from Antigua representing for Julian.
Shanakisha Francis, Miss Cool and Smooth.
We having a good time. This is Dan Winter from Antigua representing for Julian.
We'll give you a behind-the-scenes look at what it takes to be a Queen of Carnival contestant. Yes, I'm ready to see the journey. I'm sure you're ready. But are the contestants ready? We're at the screening. Let the journey begin.
All right, so we have Renika, Sharon, Nandi, Denise, Adiva. Okay, so they will be in the room with you, and they will assist you with whatever you need assistance with. Ideally, we would like to have one lady per contestant so that you have somebody who is paying attention to only you. So when you go in, you would have seen your spot, you saw your area, you set out everything. When you get inside, they all know who they're assisting. So you just go to your table and somebody will help you.
The order in which the contestants will come, what they're doing for their talent. We give you a biography for each young lady in a picture. So before they come and while they're there, you can ask them questions based on what they have in their bio, and you can ask them anything you like.
Well, hello, Akiba. How are you feeling today?
Hello, I'm feeling wonderful. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. Thanks for asking.
Wonderful,
so you
wonderful.
Are at the Queen of Carnival 2023 screening.
Yes, I am.
Are you excited?
Of course I am. I'm ready to jump out of my seat right now.
So we haven't really started anything yet, but tell us why you decided to try for Queen of Carnival 2023.
Well, I love to challenge myself. I think being a part of Queen of Carnival this year is going to allow me to grow in the capacity where I am more confident in public. I grew up very introverted, but I know this is going to bring out that bold side of me. It's already there. It's already there. And I'm just excited for the journey.
And I'm excited to see the journey as well.
Thank
what
you.
Are you going to be showing the judges today? Anything that you have for us in store?
Well, I'm going to be singing.
Ooh, okay.
Well, yes, I'm going to be singing today. Mm-hmm. My talent is music, singing. Apart from that, I'm just ready to just have a conversation mm-hmm. with the judges, them to get to know me, apart from just being a beauty queen.
Well, you know, I'm excited to see the outcome. I wish you all the best on the journey to the screening today.
Yes.
And hopefully in Queen of Carnival 2023.
Okay, thank you so much.
You're most welcome. Make your body, 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 do it for me. It's true. I'm not bend your back and cock up when you're queen. One is what make me feel like you're ready to touch. You bring down the body, the waistline, and tell me I'll lift it up. Show me all, put your hand on it. Turn around, start to rub on it.
So tell us, who is Akiba?
But Akiba is ambitious. Akiba is kind. Akiba is courageous, charming, soft. I am also very, very hardworking. Whenever I set my mind to something, I ensure that I always put my best foot forward. Put the best foot forward and leave the rest to God. That's what I always tell myself. Well, I am affiliated with the Youth Parliament. I'm not a part of the Youth Parliament, but I also have colleagues who are a part of the Youth Parliament. So we would just basically have discussions and basically say, talk about what we want to see for the country, what we want to see for our youths, our school children, even our elderly. Just conversation, basically. This is my last night.
Made it to the end of the screening. Akiba Egard, how are you feeling?
I am feeling very confident that I would have put my best foot forward. And the other girls as well. Oh, my talent. Talk about talent. Oh, my. But yes, I'm feeling great.
We just met with Akiba Egard, and now we're sitting with Ishikelly Corbing. How are you today?
I'm feeling wonderful. I must say it's really good to be back doing something like this. I haven't done it in a long time, so I'm excited to be here.
Does that mean you did Queen of Carnival before?
No, I haven't, but pageantry. I haven't done something like this in a long time, since 2015, Miss Labor Queen.
Oh, okay. So you are a hopeful 2023 contestant. Tell
yes.
us exactly why you decided to try for Queen of Carnival 2023.
Yes. So this has been a long-term goal of mine. It's something that I know my mother would have been supporting me with from the beginning to the end. I think that I represent a generation of people that are struggling to find their peace and their purpose in life. So I'm hoping to be able to use my platform to not only encourage and promote support for those struggling with mental health issues, but to help reduce the stigma that these people experience. Make your body,
bend your back and cock up when you're queen. One is what make me feel like you're ready to touch. You bring down the body, the waistline, and tell me I'll lift it up.
Why do you think we should select you to enter this Queen of Carnival competition?
I think that I represent a generation of people that are struggling to find their passion and their peace, but they're still pushing forward regardless of the challenges they face. I personally am not a perfect person, so I've been through my fair share of challenges, and I would love to use the platform as an opportunity to share my experiences and how I have overcome them while I use my platform of mental health awareness to promote support for those who are struggling with mental health.
Describe yourself in three words.
I am compassionate, I'm very driven, and I'm friendly.
Cancer! 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 A wretched word of hate that I always sees the death of those you most love and adore, that you cruelly take when you can't see them anymore. It's a destructive creature. It affects one and three. Who knows, when I'm old, it could be you, it could be me. But there is no cure. Every medical attempt to save and prevent is not good enough.
Lady in her cocktail wear, Ishikelly Corbing. The screening is finally over. Tell us a bit about how you feel. Do you think that you would have made it to actually being a contestant in Queen of Carnival?
Yes, so it was definitely a wonderful experience. As I mentioned, I haven't done something like this in a very long time, so I'm excited for the journey ahead. And I think I did really well, so fingers crossed, I'm hopeful. I like to be positive, and I think I did a good enough job to be selected.
I'm sitting with Jakeda Isaac. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And how are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing quite lovely, and you look lovely.
Thank you. So do you.
Oh, thank you. So today is Queen of Carnival 2023 screening. Yes. Tell us about your expectations for today.
Well, today I'm here to do the best that I can do so that I can be the best that I can be. And that's something that my late grandmother has instilled in me from a small child, and I use it as my motto in everyday life.
What do you think your chances are in Queen of Carnival 2023?
I think my chances are high. I'm here to succeed, and I would love to represent my country.
When your queen on the spot, make me feel like you're ready to touch. You bring down the body, the waistline, and tell me I'll lift in it up. Show me all, put your hand on it. Turn around, start to rub on it.
Jakeda, tell us about a challenge that you've had in the past and how you overcame it.
Okay, one challenge that I've had in the kitchen, because there are a lot of challenges in the kitchen, is dealing with multiple personalities and egos as head chefs and sous chefs. And one way you deal with that is to understand people, understand their ways of doing things, and learning to be flexible and to adjust depending on who you're working with. I think that's very important in understanding people and dealing with people.
I know that you're a chef.
Yes.
I have mentioned in your bio, but where do you see yourself with your career in the next 5 years?
In the next 5 years, I hope to open my own bakery here. I am a pastry chef, so I love to do sweets, entremets, baked goods, and I would love to open my own place in Antigua.
Making some nice local treats?
Yes.
Or some new local treats?
Well, I would love to incorporate our local ingredients to create beautiful and different pastries. Yes.
There is no bathroom. There are no colored bathrooms in this building or any building outside the West Campus, which is half a mile away. Did you know that? Did you know that? I have to walk to Timbuktu just to relieve myself. And I can't use one of the handy bikes. Picture that, Mr. Harrison. Picture that.
Most of the girls seem quite excited. They seem quite confident. Jakeda, how do you think your experience with the screening was today?
It was a great experience as well. I feel confident that I did great, and the other girls as well.
So you're hopeful that you will be a part of the 2023 selection. And what do you think you most enjoyed about today's screening?
I enjoyed meeting the girls.
They were all lovely, and I think we started to form a bond together, and I look forward to working with them and doing activities with them and competing with them.
You're watching Crown, the making of a carnival queen. And sitting with me is fourth on the list for today's screening, Jadenique Prince. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Thank you for asking. And how are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. Are you excited for today?
I am very excited and a little bit nervous, but I'm mostly excited.
Awesome. So today is where you get to show your skills to hopefully get into Queen of Carnival for this year. What can we expect from you?
You can expect greatness. Mm. I plan on going above and beyond everyone's expectations.
You know, that sounds like Inette. They should be your sponsor. So tell us a little bit about who you are and why you decided to enter Queen of Carnival 2023.
Well, my name is Jadenique, of course. I'm the only Jadenique because I'm unique. I'm 21 years old and I decided to enter Queen of Carnival 2023 because I have a passion for pageantry. It's always been my dream, and I have crossed the necessary path in reaching the bigger stage for today, well, hopefully for today, and I believe that anything you put your mind to, you can achieve. And with that being said, I plan on doing my very best.
So tell us about yourself.
My name is Jadenique Prince. Of course, Jade. Joyful, determined, intelligent, natural, intellectual, queen, unique, and exquisite. It's just a few words to describe me. I enjoy dancing, singing, karaoke. I cannot sing, but I can carry my own key. And I love to model. In the near future, I wish to continue my studies in hospitality management, in hopefully earning a position in the management position in hospitality.
Where do you see yourself in the next 2 years?
In the next 2 years, I see myself being a queen, first of all.
Okay.
And reaching greatness. I have a lot of things I want to accomplish. Mm-hmm. But to begin with, I really would like to continue my studies in hospitality management because it's my passion. I love customer service. Mm-hmm. I currently work at Millereef as a hostess, so I have to do a lot of speaking to customers and making sure that they leave the satisfied. And with gaining that knowledge in hospitality, it would boost my education, my mindset in becoming better at what I do. And that is where I see myself in the next 2 years.
From the very moment you arrived, I felt something new inside. I developed a love that was so unconditional.
What a lovely cocktail wear. How are you feeling about the screening today?
I'm feeling great. It was a great experience. I had fun. I had lots and lots of fun. But yeah, it was a great experience.
You know, that's really good to know. So are you hopeful or more confident that you might be a selected delegate in this year's competition?
Might is underestimated. Ooh. You have to, I believe, I am confident that I passed it.
I am sitting with Kessie and Samuel, and again, we're here at the 2023 Queen of Carnival screening. Kessie, how are you?
I'm doing lovely, thank you, and how are you?
I am doing quite well. Tell us, what do you think your chances are today being at the screening?
Well, I must say, I've met with the competition. They're not only beautiful, but they seem very intelligent. So I know the competition is stiff, but I must say, I believe I could be triumphant in this battle.
And if you were to get to that stage of being a contestant in Queen of Carnival, what can we expect from you? And why did you decide to try out today?
Experiencing pageantry in my past, I've grown a love for it, for the experience, the growth you get from it. So Antigua, Miss Antigua and Barbuda, Queen of Carnival, is known as the biggest pageant on the island. So I say, give yourself a challenge, push yourself, see what you're capable of, let others see what you are capable of, and put your best foot forward. Anything is possible.
Come now, y'all. Bend your back and cock up when your queen on the spot. Make me feel like you're ready to touch.
Tell us a little bit more about you, like, who is Kessian?
Okay. So, Kessian, when you first see her, you might think this little shy, introverted young lady. But I believe once you get to know me, you would experience that explosive, you know, personality. I would say I get along with persons very well, and as I mentioned before, I'm very passionate about what I do. So when I do something, I always want to put my best foot forward.
Well, tell me one person that you admire, either locally, regionally, or internationally.
Okay, one person I must say I admire would be my former Garmin production teacher, Ms. Shereen Gillen, because she taught me not only my favorite skill, which is constructing and designing garments and clothing, but she's also a very powerful woman. She's a single mother, you know, she's a very good teacher. She's my number one supporter, aside from my mother.
Different! That's what I am. Not less than. And certainly not deserving of your jokes and pokes. Because I sometimes see BCA instead of
ABC. You're watching Crowned, the Journey of a Carnival Queen, and we're continuing the screening recap with Kessian Samuel. How are you feeling about it?
Oh, I'm feeling pretty good about it.
I find that most of the girls said they had a good time and they're pretty confident. Tell us what you most enjoyed.
I think I enjoyed the talent the most because I got to express myself a lot.
I saw you in that swimsuit. I thought you'd have said that was your favorite one.
Well, I was kind of iffy about the swimsuit, believe it or not, because my body isn't up to where I want it to be, but they're like, you're good. The girls, they're very supportive.
So, Isha Baptiste, when I saw you coming, I wanted to stand up, but then you were so much taller than me, and that's not usual. So I said, let me sit myself down. How are you today?
I am doing wonderful. Can you tell I'm nervous?
Not really.
No, because I'm hiding it. Yes, hiding it with my excitement today.
So tell us exactly, what do you think your chances are of being a contestant in Queen of Carnival 2023?
I know that with my determination and my passion with pageantry, having the opportunity to compete in two in the past and being successful in one, I know that putting my best foot forward, I can achieve anything that I put my mind to.
I like that. And when I think about it, I think about the areas that you would be competing in today for the screening. How do you feel going into it?
I'd be very prepared.
Okay.
I have been training very hard, sleepless nights, and I know that the work will pay off. I know that everyone will see my passion, my elegance, my poise today, and it's just a wonderful experience I'm just looking forward to, and I know for a fact I'm going to have fun today.
Can't cock up when you're queen on the spot. Make me feel like you're ready to touch. You bring down the body, the waistline, I tell
you. You think you should select you to be a contestant today?
I most definitely believe so.
Why?
I bring my uniqueness.
Not only is my height outstanding, but my ability to bring such presence and vibrance to a room. I know that I am able to inspire young women as myself, that this is a dream that anyone can accomplish as long as they put their mind to and determination to achieve anything that they want in life.
Felicia, I see that in your bio, you mentioned that you are a reserved young lady. This pageant, it requires, you know, a lot of confidence and personality and so on. How do you see, if you're selected for this pageant, do you see yourself breaking out of your shell? Or how do you see yourself breaking out of your shell?
I do. That is actually my superpower. Mm-hmm. I might be shy, I might be reserved, but once I am on that stage, I become a totally different person. I had the chance to compete in two pageants in the past, and I was successful in one. Although the other one was not as successful, it was experience that I know helped build me. It helped build my character, my public speaking ability, and just my presence on stage. So I know that this show will just be a walk in the park for me.
Matt used to be one of my clients. He was so sweet, always made me laugh and smile. But I haven't smiled since having our daughter. Matt changed after she was born. He started drinking more, stayed out later than usual, complained that I was trying to change him. The house was never clean enough for him. Matt said that I gained too much weight after giving birth. He got so angry once that he beat me until I was unconscious.
Well, you have the camera guy saying he needs to get a stool for me. You a tall glass of champagne. Would you call yourself that?
I would say red wine.
Okay. But, you know, tell us about how you feel about the screening process that you went through today.
I must say it was a wonderful experience. I went in a tad bit nervous, but I kept my smile going. I kept the energy up, and it was such... Oh, I can do it again. I can do it again.
Well, you know what? I hope that you get into the next step of it. The next step would be Queen of Carnival. So you'll be able to do it again and maybe even more. How confident are you that you may make it in?
I am very confident. I went in, I put my best foot forward. I made myself proud, my trainer proud. And I know whatever God has in store for me, it will come true.
I'm sitting with Theanna Sebastian, and I know that your face may look quite familiar to many. You know what I'm going to say? Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, I'm 26 years old, Theanna Sebastian, and I'm a dance instructor at the Ministry of Sports, Education and Creative Industries, and I'm a principal dance choreographer at the Elite Dancers Antigua.
All right. So tell us exactly why you decided to try for Queen of Carnival 2023.
I do believe that everything happens at this time, and I think that this year is my time. I want to take this opportunity to show young girls, or anybody actually, that it doesn't matter if there's a fire, you can always be victorious, because at the end of the day, that fire might just be the light that leads you to your destination.
Oh, I'm so inspired. I'm just gonna sit back. Woo. So, tell us, what can we expect from you in the screening, actually?
You can expect some excitement. I'm excited to see myself in that screening as well. For years, I've been dodging the question of, should I enter? And now I'm really excited to just go into the screening and be very hopeful that I can be in Queen of Carnival 2023. Body, body, make your body, make your body, make your body, make your body.
Come now, yeah. Bend your back and cock up when you're queen. One is what make me feel like you're ready to touch.
Yeah, I see that you have quite some different experience in pageantry based on your vibe. Has that been somewhat of an encouragement for you to enter the Queen of Carnival pageant? And what do you hope to gain if you're selected?
My experience in pageantry did actually give me some of a boost to enter Queen of Carnival this year, and I hope by entering this pageant that I can use this as an opportunity to help to inspire the youth. I mean, everybody has a story, and I want to use this platform to tell mine.
If you were selected, you were crowned queen, and you had to be an ambassador for Antigua and Barbuda. Can you sell Antigua to me in 30 seconds, please?
If you like to stand, excuse me, if it's more comfortable for you to express yourself, that's fine.
Antigua and Barbuda is a place where everybody can be called family. It's a place where we are comfortable with each other, and I would love for everybody to come here and be as one. It's a country that is rich in culture, and this is what we use every year to come together at one point, which is Antigua's Carnival. We are just happy to be around each other. Antigua and Barbuda's main industry is tourism, and I do believe that tourism and culture goes hand in hand.
I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. Does it take a trophy to make you proud? I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Ooh.
We've made it to our final delegate, Theana Sebastian. How are you feeling after the screening?
I'm feeling excited now that it's all over. I was nervous, but I'm good. I'm good now.
And what do you think your chances are? You feeling confident? Most of the girls said they're excited.
I do feel confident. I was actually sitting down speaking with the girls, and I'm telling them I cannot wait for this journey for us to start. So I hope that my wishes and the judges' wishes are the same.
That's a good one. I said I was crossing my toes and my fingers. Well, you guys seem to have a good bond already, so I really do wish you guys all the best. Before you go, what was your favorite part of the journey this afternoon?
My favorite segment was the interview. So they asked me a lot of questions, and I was really excited to get those. So hopefully in the future, if they do ask me those questions, I will be good and ready.
I know you're hearing me, but you're not seeing me. That's because it's not about me. We've made it to the end of the screening, and I wish the girls all the best on this exciting journey. Can I get through maybe? Just a little bit. Yeah. So my name is Raynell Carroll, and you've been watching Crowned, the Journey of a Carnival Queen.
Crowned is brought to you in association with Splinters Beauty Salon, Tortura Gym Antigua, Neverland, West Indies Oil Company Limited, Art and Capital Antigua, Furniture Gallery, Cedar Valley Golf Course, Cool and Smooth, and Antigua Port Authority.
Hello, my name is Raynell Carroll, and welcome back. Here we are at phase two. I'm sure you're guessing exactly what that is, and we have our Enchanted Seven. And I'm sure you're just as excited as me to see who the selected seven were. It's going to be a magical experience. I'm sure you can see the backdrop behind of me. And I'm already loving the atmosphere, the energy. Let's see who our seven delegates are for Queen of Carnival Miss Antigua Barbuda 2023.
Akiba Agard, Miss Furniture Gallery. Jakeda Isaac, Miss Cool and Smooth. Theana Sebastian, Miss West Indies Oil Company Limited. Ishi Kelly Corbing, Miss Cedar Valley Golf Course. Kessianne Samuel, Miss Art and Capital Antigua. Jadenee Prince, Miss Neverland. Sawisha Baptiste, Miss Antigua Port Authority.
Girl, sweet like guava jam.
Yeah.
Sweet like guava jam.
So
girl, sweet like guava jam.
Yeah.
Sweet like guava jam.
Hi everyone, I'm
Jakeda Isaac, Queen of Carnival contestant 2023. When I got the call, I was very excited, and I was also very proud of myself. I had a very short time to prepare, so I really pushed myself for the screening, and I'm just so happy to be here, and I really look forward to the show this year.
Hi, my name is Soisha Baptist, a Queen of Carnival 2023 contestant. Honestly, I was so nervous, so scared when I got that call, but when I heard Basila's voice on the phone, I was like, yes, girl, you got in. And I was so ecstatic. I was so happy. I couldn't even control my happiness at work, but I had to put on a straight face and get the work done. And going forward in this competition, I'm just hoping to have fun with all the girls, create such a memory and experience. And I know it's going to be a great show. See you guys there.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jadenique Prince, and I am one of the contestants for Queen of Carnival 2023. When I got the call, I felt butterflies in my stomach. I was like, yes, I got in. And I knew I could have done it from the get-go, but the reassurance that I got from Brucella was just exceptional. My expectations for the show is all greatness. I plan on working together with the young ladies, the other contestants, as a team and having as much fun as we can have. And anything that puts smiles on everyone's faces, you know, I'm there. But that is my expectations.
Hi, everyone. I am Thiana Sebastian, a contestant in this year's Queen of Carnival 2023. When I got the call that I became a contestant, honestly, I cried. Usually, I am in doubt of myself, but obviously, they saw something in me to give me the opportunity to be in this pageant. And what I can say is that I am going to be hopeful. At the end of the day, my job is to go and showcase myself and my true talent, and I hope that everyone sees it on the night of the competition.
Good evening, Antigua and Barbuda. I am Ishikelly Corbin, a contestant in this year's Miss Antigua competition. When I got the call, I was very excited. I was also just a little bit sad because I did wish I could share the news with my mom, but I knew that she was proud of me and that she's watching the journey going forward. My expectation for the show is that win or lose, I come out at the end a transformed woman, and I'm also hoping to foster new relationships with the fellow ladies who will be competing alongside myself while also building a new network.
Hello, the beautiful people of Antigua and Barbuda. My name is Akiba Chelsea Agard, and I am one of the beautiful contestants in this year's Queen of Carnival 2023. I would love to say that I was not nervous about auditioning, the screening, the entire process, but I was. I believe I gave my best foot forward. I put my best foot forward, and when I got that call, I was so excited and so happy to know that I would have made the cut. My expectations for Queen of Carnival this year is that it will be explosive, it will be dynamic, and it will be one of the best, if not the best, one of the best. I also expect myself and the other contestants to build a better community of pageantry. I expect us to do our best, and whosoever is the winner, God be with her, represent our country best, the best way possible, and just good luck to all the other girls.
When I got the call, I was so excited. I must say, my expectations for this pageant is to not only form a sisterhood with these other girls, but I do expect stiff competition because I see the talent in these young ladies, and I must say, I'm looking forward for, you know, a joyful time and a good learning experience.
On behalf of the Ministry of Creative Industries, specifically the Honorable Daryl Matthew, who's out of state, he's unable to be here tonight. We just want to congratulate all of you for making it this step forward. We're really excited, and specifically me, you know, being the junior minister in the Ministry of Creative Industries, I would have worked with Brucella over many years, and I've always loved pageantry, having been a chaperone and adjudicator. So I'm hoping that this year could be a queen show that everybody will not forget.
Good evening, ladies. Our enchanted seven. Look at you all, beautiful, stunning, and intelligent. I just love it. You encompass everything a woman should be. Confident, beautiful, and intelligent. And so moving forward, I want you to remember that word, enchanted. That is our theme for this year's Queen of Carnival. I'd like to officially welcome you as a contestant in the competition and to let you know that the journey is going to be tough. It is going to be rough. You will have days that you may feel like giving up, but we're women, we were born strong. And so I know when those days come, you will just cry, you'll wipe your tears, and you will move forward. Okay, I know that you will do this. So I'm looking forward to a really great experience with all of you. I am looking forward to you enjoying the journey. It's not so much about the destination. I find that many times when girls enter these shows, they focus too much on winning. And I want you to focus on winning because I want you to want to win. But I don't want you to focus on winning so much that the experience that is the most important passes you by. As you can see on the folders, we have started with our theme, enchanted, our little backdrop, you know, mythical, mesmerizing, whimsical, everything that women love. Butterflies, what is that? There's a little nursery rhyme, I can't remember it, but it's a song. Raindrops and all right, enough of me. Oh, these are a few of my favorite things. Okay, well, you know what I'm talking about.
Girl, sweet like guava jam,
yeah.
Sweet like guava jam.
So what happened?
Girl, sweet like guava jam, yeah. Sweet like guava jam.
Say you love me.
Your keep.
The Enchanted Seven, and I can comfortably say that Jakeda Isaac is a contestant in this year's Queen of Carnival Miss Antigua Barbuda pageant. And even though numbers have not yet been selected, I'm sure she's quite excited. How was the orientation tonight for you?
The orientation is going very well, very productive. We're getting a lot of information that's going to be very helpful to us for this enchanted ride for Queen of Carnival, so I'm very excited.
So tell us about the theme that you selected tonight.
So for my costume, the theme that I got was our lovely beaches. And I'm very, very happy with that because not only is it at the heart of who we are as Antiguans, but it's also my happy place. When I'm feeling sad or I'm feeling anxious and I envision my happy place, it's always the beach because I have such fond memories with my family at the beach. I love listening to the waves crash on the shore and just being in that surrounding with nature. It's amazing and I can't wait to instill that in my costume.
I think we should create a happy dance because you were quite elated, quite confident on the first day that we met. So I'm happy to see that here we are at the next step. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And how do you feel about the orientation? What are you looking forward to the most? Tell us about your theme as well.
Where do I start? Well, first of all, my theme is pineapple. I don't know where to start. It's a very wide topic. I know it's Antiguan national fruit. And expect greatness. Expect something different out of the box, above and beyond your expectations. The orientation has been quite interesting. I've learned a lot, whether about the beaches, about steel pan, about mass, and I have been introduced to the entire team, Marsha Marsh Production, whereas they have been very welcoming, and I expect greatness, and I can't wait. I'm excited.
I think I should grab a chair to stand on, but I am with Soisha Baptiste, and yes, a contestant in this year's Queen of Carnival competition. Woohoo! Let's do a happy dance. Swing. Hey. How do you feel? And tell us about the theme that you selected tonight.
My theme is mass for my costume segment, and it's my favorite time of the year. I'm so happy that I got this theme so that I can showcase our culture and our heritage in such a glamorous and elegant way on stage. So look out, mask from Soisha Baptiste.
The Enchanted Seven. You know what we should do? Tell me what number you hope to pick whenever that time comes.
Number one.
Okay, brave and ready.
Yes, you gotta lead. And then it's very exciting because you always get the thrill and then the audience see you first. I guess they remember you. They always remember you.
So you want to be that one, number one.
Number one, because I'm hoping to be the one.
I like it, actually. So the theme you selected tonight is?
Well, I selected our majestic national bird, the frigate bird. It's a beautiful bird, so I'm really excited. I already have ideas popping into my head.
You know, I particularly like that one because when we think of the nation, Antigua and Barbuda, we always have to remember our sister island, Barbuda. And in this occasion, this Queen of Carnival, we definitely did not leave Barbuda out. So I'm excited to see what you'll bring in that regard. How do you feel about the orientation?
I feel like it's quite informative. It actually sets everything in stone for me. You know, everything is real. This is happening. You're going to do this and you're going to do your best.
I'm standing with Thiana Sebastian, another contestant in this year's show. And tonight, she selected a theme.
Calypso and soca.
Are you excited about this one?
Yes, I'm very excited to have received calypso and soca. I mean, it's a topic that is very close to home, so I'm very excited to showcase what it's all about. I mean, I am calypso and soca.
I think that's a good way to look at it. About this orientation tonight, how do you feel about the segments for the competition? What are you most looking forward to?
I am very excited for the segments, and I am very excited for the talent segment. I'm very much aware of what my theme is going to be, and I know for sure that it's going to work in cohesive with the theme of the pageant. And I'm very excited.
when I'm standing with Ishi Kelly, I have to say, is she Kelly, right?
She is.
So tonight you selected a theme for the costume segment, and I've basically asked all of the girls what is their theme, what they feel about it. So tell us about yours.
The theme that I selected is the steel pan, and I feel very excited about it because it's going to be a great way to pay some homage to our culture and to share a little bit about it. So I'm very excited.
And tonight, you officially are a contestant in the Queen of Carnival competition. You have met your other six, I want to say contenders, but I'd say sisterhood friends. How do you feel about the entire orientation process, the segments to come?
Overall, I'm very grateful. I'm thankful to have been selected as a contestant, and I'm very excited for the journey ahead. Like I said, I'm really trying to work on myself, and I'm really passionate about the journey that is about to go forward because the girls are very wonderful, and I know that we're going to have such a good time together.
Akiba Agard, officially a Queen of Carnival, Miss Antigua Barbuda contestant 2023. How excited are you?
I am very, very excited. I am so honored to have been selected to be a part of the contestants this year. Antigua, look out for 23. Look out for me.
And the theme you selected tonight is?
Cuisine. I got cuisine. And actually, I'm a foodie, so...
you too? Me and you?
Well, yes, I got cuisine, and honestly, I'm actually excited because I love Caribbean food. I am from Indian background, and I know what it's like to put down a good meal. So I am very, very excited to go into our cuisine. Very, very excited.
The orientation would not be complete without a quick chat with the official hair and makeup artist, John Clark, the founder of Splinters Beauty Salon.
We'll be able to make more suggestions as to what we'll do from there forward. Yeah, we will definitely make different suggestions and change up your looks and so forth. But I know for the night of the show, I would assume that we'll be maybe using a full wig for the night of the show, since your hair is natural. Or if you want to use your natural hairstyle, we can work with it as well. It's not a problem. It's optional to you. It's a good thing you're sitting and I'm standing. Okay, so I'm John.
Soisha.
Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Soisha.
Soisha? So. Okay, so. As you know, I'm John, right? And I'm definitely looking forward to work with you. Right. I am not sure you're natural, right? Okay, that's not an issue. I work with a lot of natural hair. I know a lot of natural hair person have do's and don'ts. You are the first person with relaxed hair tonight. Everyone is natural. Okay, all right. So, as you know, I am John, and I am the one that will be doing your hair and makeup. And I am looking forward to work with you girls. And I know a lot of people are waiting to see what's coming, right? So we all have to come together and make it, you know, wow factor. Now, I know sometimes people have do's and don'ts about what they like and what they don't like where their hair is concerned. I'm always prepared and ready to work with anyone based on your event, what look you want to try to achieve, and I will deliver.
Can sweet like guava jam, sweet like guava jam.
So
can sweet like guava jam, sweet like guava jam.
Say you love me, touch my body. I just think that I dance.
There we have it. We came to the end of our orientation session. I must remind you that our reigning Queen of Carnival is Shanakisha Francis, Queen of Carnival 2019. She's also the JC's Caribbean Queen. This evening, we got a taste of what you can expect for the 2023 show. I'm excited. I hope you are. And we wish to keep you on this journey to crown the making of a Carnival Queen. See you next week.